Hello, and a very warm welcome to LNT Royal YouTube channel. The good news that we want to send to everyone today. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry are pictured for the first time in Los Angeles delivering food packages during lockdown for a non-profit in masks and gloves after Duchess wanted her husband to see the city through the eyes of philanthropy. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry have been pictured in Los Angeles for the first time, LNT Royal Channel can exclusively show. The Duke and Duchess were seen delivering food packages on behalf of the Los Angeles-based nonprofit project Angel Food on Wednesday. Harry and Meghan were captured on surveillance cameras arriving at the Sierra Bonita Community Apartments in West Hollywood in their SUV at 10:55 a.m. A security team accompanied the couple in a separate SUV that followed closely behind, but they opted to walk up to the apartment to deliver the food alone. Dressed casually in jeans, Harry and Meghan both followed California's new rules regarding face coverings issued by Gov. Gavin Newsom on April 15. Meghan and Harry spent 2 days volunteering with a non-profit this week, who cook and deliver meals to people with critical illness, who are at a greater risk amid the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. None of the charity's clients knew the Duke and Duchess were going to be delivering the food, nor had any been forewarned about their arrival. One stunned recipient of the royal delivery was Dan Tyrell, who admitted he didn't recognize the couple when he first opened the door of his West Hollywood apartment. Tyrell, who has issues with high blood pressure, said, "My phone rang and a lady said, 'Hi, this is Meghan from Project Angel Food.' I said, 'Oh, do you want to meet me downstairs?' I didn't realize it was the Meghan at this point." Tyrell said he was startled when he walked down the building's external staircase and spotted two black out SUVs on the road outside. He remarked, "I knew there was something going on." As he approached the front door, Tyrell said he spotted a man with red hair who looked familiar. He said, "Then I looked at Meghan and put it all together, attempting to keep a low profile. Neither Harry nor Meghan formally introduced themselves to Tyrell. Instead, they told him, 'Here's your food and thank you. We hope you're well and that you're fine.'" Tyrell said, "I didn't let on that I knew who they were. I didn't want to make them uncomfortable or anything. To have someone come and deliver the food is amazing. It makes us here feel that somebody cares outside. So for Harry and Meghan to do this is amazing." The Sussexes moved to Los Angeles from Vancouver Island, Canada, in late March amid speculation about who would foot the bill for the royal couple's security detail. It's unclear who funded the two security detail in the SUVs that escorted the Duke and Duchess around Los Angeles on Wednesday, but the couple were warned by President Trump on March 30th that America certainly wouldn't be covering the cost. In response, Meghan and Harry assured the president they were never going to ask in the first place. A statement from a spokesperson for the couple said at the time, "The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have no plans to ask the U.S. government for security resources. Privately funded security arrangements have been made." The palace later refused to comment about whether this meant UK taxpayers would no longer have to contribute towards any future bill. Another report: Prince Harry and Meghan plans to buy Mel Gibson's $15 million five-bedroom mansion in Malibu. Meghan Markle and Prince Harry held talks over Mel Gibson's Malibu mansion, but walked away without buying it. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex have been linked to the Lethal Weapon star's $15 million home overlooking the Pacific Ocean. The couple were said to be interested in snapping up the stunning five-bedroom home, which came with 5 acres of grounds and a private beach club membership. But a Hollywood source said, there were conversations between brokers for Mel and brokers for Meghan and Harry. The talks were preliminary, and they never got close to finalizing a deal. "I'm not sure who ended the talks. Mel's house has been on and off the market for some time." Meghan and Harry have relocated to California from their $15 million bolt hole on remote Vancouver Island, in Canada. They were reportedly focusing their house search on the Malibu neighborhood, 30 miles from Los Angeles. Andrea Pilot, who works for real estate firm Compass in Los Angeles, posted on Instagram last week claiming that Meghan Harry had bought the Malibu mansion of Gibson, she said, big news. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle buy Mel Gibson's house in Malibu. The 6,758-square-foot home, in Malibu's Carbon Mesa area, overlooks both the Pacific Ocean in front of it and a green canyon behind it. It has 5 bedrooms, 5 acres of grounds, walk-in closets, an exceptional chef's kitchen, a gym, and 2 ocean-view swimming pools. The mansion, which used to be owned by the X-Files star David Duchovny, also comes with a membership to a beach club. Randon Williams, who had listed Gibson's home on the website of his firm Williams and Williams Estates Group, declined to comment. In other news, Meghan Markle and Prince Harry initially planned to name their charitable foundation Arkway, but had to ditch the name and opt for Arkwell instead. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex confirmed last week that they would be calling their non-profit Arkwell after their son and the Greek word for source of action. But trademark paperwork appears to show that the name was not their first choice. The couple submitted an application for Arkway with the United States Patent and Trademark Office on February 28. That application, which was obtained by LMT Royal Channel, was then axed by the couple just a week later on March 6. The owner of the trademark application withdrew the application, and the application is no longer active. The Arkway application is now marked as dead. 4 days after abandoning Arkway, a new application was sent by the couple's attorney seeking to trademark Arkwell. That application was quickly followed by a number of others who hoped to capitalize from the name when they learned Meghan and Harry were trademarking it for their company. Meghan and Harry have only submitted Arkwell for trademark in the US, however, much like they only sought to trademark Sussex Royal in the UK last year before dropping that application. Last week, they confirmed the news in a brief statement from California. The couple said in a statement, "Like you, our focus is on supporting efforts to tackle the global COVID-19 pandemic, but faced with this information coming to light, we felt compelled to share the story of how this came to be." Before Sussex Royal came the idea of Archie, the Greek word meaning source of action. "We connected to this concept for the charitable organization we hoped to build one day, and it became the inspiration for our son's name," the statement continued. "To do something of meaning, to do something that matters." Arkwell is a name that combines an ancient word for strength and action, and another that evokes the deep resources we each must draw upon. "We look forward to launching Arkwell when the time is right." Meghan and Harry are now members of the private sector after stepping down from their royal duties last month. Another analysis: Meghan Markle donned $228 relaxed boyfriend shirt by LA-based brand and trendy Adidas Stan Smith trainers to deliver food to vulnerable people in the city. The Duchess of Sussex donned a $228 relaxed boyfriend shirt from an LA-based brand and a pair of trendy Adidas Stan Smith trainers as she delivered food to vulnerable people in the city this week. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, who moved to Los Angeles last month, volunteered with charity project Angel Food on Easter Sunday and returned on Wednesday to drop off non-perishable meals to 20 more vulnerable people in the city. The Duchess selected a relaxed outfit for the volunteering, opting for an oversized white shirt from one of her favorite brands Frank and Eileen, black skinny jeans, as well as a pair of trendy trainers. The royal also slung a pair of $48 Luspex sunglasses across her shirt and added a bold blue volunteering cap to her outfit, which was pulled low across her face. The LA-based Frank and Eileen is believed to be a favorite of Meghan's, with the royal previously wearing the relaxed shirt as she traveled from Australia's Fraser Island to Fiji during the couple's 2018 tour of the countries. During their volunteering stint, the Duchess was also believed to have been wearing her suitable's horoscope necklace. The delicate gold pendant features a Taurus charm, giving a gentle nod to her son Archie's horoscope ahead of his upcoming first birthday on the 6th of May. Please support growing LMD Royal Channel by subscribe channel, like and share videos us. Your support is the motivation for us to produce better videos. Don't stop. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more LMT Royal videos about your favorite royals are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.